Vivienne. I'm at the Paul Mitchell School in Costa. No, I'm not Costa Mesa. Modesto. Modesto. Something Spanish sounding. I don't know. It's been a very long life. Anyway, this is Breanna, and she is so tired of her long hair. So I'm going to put an elastic band in it, and I don't know whether it. Oh, see how thick her hair is? I'm going to do it again. I'm going to put an elastic band in her hair, and guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to cut it all off. Ah, are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
You ready? Tell everyone on camera.
I'm ready.
So here you can see I deep into the haircut. I've already established my classic graduation in the nape of the neck, and I have some softness around the face. So it's a combination of scissors and razor working in a classic round graduation. Here you can see I'm working with my razor, and I'm going to be working in lovely long strokes, ever so soft and very light, going very gracefully through the hair. And Breanna has extremely thick hair, very, very coarse and strong. So this lightness and softness around the face, I think, is really super. So we've got the strength in the back and the softness in the front. So as you can see, I'm having fun. I'm at the Paul Mitchell School. We've got my friend with the iPad just taking some shots. So you can see this is really sort of a rough kind of edit, but I just wanted to share with you some of the things I do when I go on the road, and makeovers is one of my favorite things to do. Going into the top of the hair, here you can see we're layering. Very important to hold the razor is almost as though I'm shaking a hand. I take my hand up and I swing. In this case, I'm swinging from my wrist, over-directing the hair back, and the goal here is to connect my internal layers into my external graduation. So we've got the strength of the graduation sitting from the nape to the occipital bone, taken with diagonal sections. Here we have the top where we're taking long layers, over-directing backwards so that we can create a nice soft front. Just fluffing the hair here, you can see how beautiful that graduation is. She actually has a very strong hairline. And what I want to see is that wonderful ledge of rounded weight. And as I'm drying the hair, I'm looking to see the balance. This really is a wash and wear hairstyle. And as I'm drying it, it's just very, very free because this really is cut to her hair texture. Scissor over comb is vital. The attention to detail, my comb and my blade is tilted away from the head. Rhythm is important. And being very, very methodical, I almost count inside, one, two, one, two, one, two, to get that nice rhythm going. Make sure that when you're working on graduation, you don't look just straight at your work. You come and look sideways to look at the depth to make sure that you're creating a beautiful shape. And here you can see, as the hair is falling, this beautiful movement and just a lovely texture.
Okay guys, so this amazing hair belongs to this beautiful young lady. How do you feel about your look?
I love it. It was a big change. But...
give us a spin, baby.
You look cool?
Hot. Gorgeous.